Hello and welcome to YouTube channel Health Cube, the place where my mission is to motivate you to look at the brighter side of the health. In today's video, I'm going to demonstrate you two most important breathing exercises that would be helpful if you are suffering from scoliosis. What is scoliosis and how it impacts your day-to-day life? I've already made one video on it. The link to that video would be mentioned in the description box below. So make sure to check it out. But in today's video, we will learn breathing exercise which would be helpful in scoliosis. So make sure to watch this video till the end. Let's begin. Friends, even scoliosis is a postural problem. It impacts your breathing. It impacts your lung function and thus makes your overall health and well-being worse. If your scoliosis is not corrected or if you do not manage your scoliosis on time, the things can get worsened and it might lead to further problems. And that's why it is important that you work on your scoliosis management as soon as possible. The thing that you should start working on when you are having scoliosis is breathing exercises, absolutely. Because breathing exercises will make sure that your diaphragm expands and functions well. Second, your ribs open well properly so that your movements of your rib and your spine is well maintained. And third, your oxygen reaches properly to your entire lung and your alveoli so that the oxygen exchange happens well and your body gets enough oxygen. And that's why breathing exercises are super important when it comes to scoliosis. So here are two most important breathing exercises that you should do for your scoliosis. Let's begin. So the first thing that you need to do before doing breathing exercise for scoliosis is to figure out which side of your body or as your spine is compressed, which side is elongated. In order to find this out, make sure to keep your two hands around the ribs. Close your eyes and try to expand your chest. When you will expand your chest, you will observe that one side of your ribs or as your chest is expanding quite well, but one side is not expanding enough. That side which is not expanding enough is a compressed side where your spine is getting compressed and there your lung function is getting impaired or as the movements on that side are limited at your ribs level. And that's where you need to try to bring on more air and you need to focus on more respiration. Hence, now what you're going to do is you are going to try to keep your hand on side, which is the compressed side, and try to expand and breathe on that side further. So try to fill more air on this side of your lung. Reason it's important to keep your hand on the ribs is to give feedback to yourself that yes, you are trying to fill more air on that side. It's important that you make sure that you breathe in from your nose and breathe out from your nose while you are doing this process, or else you can breathe in from the nose and breathe out from the mouth. But make sure not to inhale from your mouth while doing this exercise. So this forms your exercise number one. The second breathing exercise needs to be done in sleeping position. For this, you will need two pillows. So here are my two pillows which I have taken. Now I need to sleep in a way that my compressed side that we saw which had limited lung expansion, which was not expanding well, comes on the above or else on the top and not on the bottom. And I will place my pillows in a way that my lung area comes there in this way. So this would be my sleeping position. If you want, you can also bend your legs while sleeping. And now, what you're going to do is, you're going to stretch your hand out this way. And then you will use this hand and place it here. And now try to expand your lungs. Observe that this side of your lung is more moving up and is moving down as you inhale and exhale. So this forms your exercise number two. Now let's have a look at the third exercise. In order to do the third exercise, what you're going to do is, you're going to keep one hand on the side, other hand on your waistline, and then you will breathe in and you will bend down. Now, the direction in which you're going to bend is opposite to the area where your lungs are compressed. So it's always important to check first which side of your ribs are not getting expanded well. The area where there is less expansion, that needs to be stretched and you need to bend on other side. So for example, if this is a compressed area or this side of my lung are not expanding well, I will keep my hand on the opposite side of the waist. Opposite side of the waist, and then I will bend on that side. And you will relax. You can do all of these exercises for almost 5 to 10 repetitions and gradually increase it. Remember, doing these exercises regularly will improve your breathing capacity, it will improve your functions of diaphragm, and it will also help you and your posture to get better day by day. Hence, it's important to take it seriously and do it daily. I hope you found this video helpful. If yes, make sure to like this video, share this video with your friends and family members, and do not forget to subscribe to HealthQ channel. I'll see you in another video. Thank you.